Carr A. Nation, a leader of the temperance movement of the late 1800s, was probably the most violent person in American history. In fact, it was said that Carr was psychotic from an early age.
I'm home.
It's 2 in the morning, you family killer!
Carrie's first husband, Charles Gloyd, was an alcoholic. Together, they had a daughter, Charlene. Their marriage wasn't happy, and Carr divorced him because he couldn't support their family. In 1869, 3 months after the divorce, he died.
However, Carr's start on the temperance movement wasn't due to death. Carr's daughter, Charlene, suffered from emotional problems, and in 1905, she was taken to the Texas State Lunatic Asylum. Carr blamed these emotional problems on her ex-husband's alcohol abuse.
All right, I'm here to take you to the asylum.
Her acts of rage started small, using crude tools to deface taverns and saloons, but quickly they grew into extremely violent acts.
Carr then founded the Women's Christian Temperance Union, or WCTU, and her group of fellow temperance activists became known as the Home Defenders.
Who are we?
Home Defenders!
I can't hear you!
Home Defenders!
1, 2, 3!
Home Defenders!
Tom Flanagan, isn't it?
Hi, guys.
He's on Friday all the time. Really be.
But even that wasn't enough for Carr.
All right, ladies, send them in. Unfortunately, due to her violence, Carr A. Nation was arrested several times.
Madam, I must arrest you for defacing property.
Defacing?
I'm destroying! Yeah, I'm still gonna have to ask you to put down the hatchet and come with me. I'm here today with Carr A. Nation to talk about her most recent arrest. How are you today, Mrs. Nation? Oh, I understand. It must be very hard to be separated from your husband for so long. How does he affect your motivation in the temperance movement?
Well, he was the one who gave me the idea to use a hatchet. Other than that, I really just married him for the money and for his last name, so I can carry this nation to prohibition!
That's romantic.
Due to her methods of promoting the temperance movement and her attempts to legalize prohibition in America, it is obvious that Carr A. Nation can be considered the most violent woman in American history. Unfortunately, she did not live to see the 18th Amendment put into place.